What's going on, guys? Dr. Brute7 signing in back with another tutorial video. So I'm going to show you guys how to install and use DBI Homebrew app. It is a very essential homebrew app that helps you to back up saves, install games through game cards. You can also transfer files that are over 4 GB without having to split them through any other softwares. This homebrew app is going to do it for you. Also, you would be able to install games through your PC, and there are other stuffs that you are able to do. However, I won't be able to show all of them to you, but I'm going to be covering the most essential ones. So let's go on ahead and install the app first. Just go to the link in the description and download DBI config and DBI NRO. Create a folder named DBI on your PC and paste those downloaded files. Connect your SD card, or you can connect it remotely via FTPD. Once you're in the root of your SD card, look for the switch folder. Just copy the DBI folder that you have created and paste it into the switch folder, something like this. After following those steps, download dbibackend.exe for your PC. Now, this is not an installer, it's just an exe file that is going to be needed in order to transfer files or install them to your Nintendo Switch. So I'll just show them all in details on the Nintendo Switch. After following those steps, just access your homebrew menu and look for the DBI app. Now, if for any reason the app crashes, just go ahead and access full RAM mode. So here I'll be showing you guys some of the most important features, which includes browse saves and how to back those up, install any title from USB, install any games via game cards. So let's just start with browsing the SD card. So here you are going to find all these stuffs that are copied on the SD card. So you can copy and paste any NSP or XCI files that you have backed up through your game cards. You can just install them through the SD card browser. You can also here browse all the installed applications that you have on your Switch. This not just shows just the installed applications, but also all the details related to the application. For example, I am playing Skyward Sword HD. So if I select this by pressing A, it's going to give all the details, the versions, the updates, playtime hours. As you can see, I have played 61 hours and 44 minutes, and total launches, everything that you want to know. You can also launch the title through here by pressing the L3 button. So there is a lot of things that can be done. You can clean up orphaned files that are taking a lot of space, unnecessary space on your Nintendo Switch. There you go, all these files, as you can see, 79 unused files, tickets and stuffs have been deleted that were taking space. You can browse saves, all these saves that exists. Just select one of these by pressing the plus button, and then just you can back up the save. There you go, this is how you back up saves. Now I'm going to show you guys how to install XCI or NSP files through the USB and through a game card. So now I'm going to show you guys how to install games through game cards and also game backups that exists on your PC. So let's just start with the Pokemon Shield. So I'm going to be using Pokemon Shield and Luigi's Mansion 3 for the demonstration process. Okay, let's just start with Shield first. Insert the game card into the slot, run the DBI app. The app is not going to detect the game card if you insert it while the app is running. You're going to see this option that says install from game card. Go ahead and press A, and here you would be getting two options. Install target. You can install it on the NAND, on the SD, or set it to auto. I'm going to be selecting SD. You can toggle the options by pressing A each time. Turn off screen, no, and then start install. Once the installation process completes, you would be able to run the game without having to insert the game card again. So this is a very cool and essential feature. Let's just say you don't want to lose your game cards or don't want to carry them while traveling. You can install them through your game card. You'll be able to run them hassle-free. Alright guys, so the installation has been completed. As you can see, it took 5 minutes and 40 seconds. It depends on the size of the game. It might be less for you. It might take a little bit longer. So yeah, once the installation has been completed, it's safe to take out this cart, and here you go. The game is running without having to insert the game card. So yeah, this is how you install games through game cards and run them without having to insert them into your slot. So if you want to delete the installed apps, just go ahead, scroll to the app, press A and press on the plus button and say delete record. You can also transfer the game to your system memory. If I'm not wrong, there is an option for that. Just press the plus button again. It says move title to NAND, so you would be able to do that as well. Okay, so now let's move on to installation of backups via PC. Alright guys, so let's just install Luigi's Mansion 3 through the DBI installer. So all you have to do is just go ahead and run the DBI backend.exe file that I have showed you guys to download. This is going to pop up. After that, just connect your Switch using a compatible USB-C cable. Just keep in mind, a lot of the USB-C cables don't detect the Switch once connected, so please use a compatible one. After that, just run the DB installer. Go to install title from USB. Go ahead and select it, and it says waiting for DB backend to be run. So we already have DB backend running. Just go ahead and add files. You can also add folders all at once. Let's just say if you have DLCs or updates for that game, you can just put those files all together and select the folder. Here I only have the file of the game that I have backed up. I selected the game and click on open. As you can see, start server has been highlighted. Go ahead and click on start server. You can see here that Luigi's Mansion 3 has been detected. Go ahead, press on A, and I'm going to select SD. As you can see that it has started with the installation process. I'm going to be back once the process has been fully completed. Alright guys, so the installation process has been completed. Now let's just go ahead and run the game. So yeah, this is how you use DBI app on your Nintendo Switch. I guess I have covered almost all of the most important aspects of the app. However, there are some more additional stuffs that you might want to take a look at. Please go to the link in the description, check them out in details. If you have found this tutorial useful and if you find my channel useful in general, please drop in a like and subscribe to show the support. I am very much active on my channel. Don't forget to comment with any kind of questions you have. Please don't forget to check out my latest tutorial video where I show how to jailbreak the Switch on its latest firmware in under 5 minutes. How informative and fast is that? To the new viewers, please make sure to check that out. I have a separate playlist for that. Also, to all the viewers, all my viewers, there are some hidden clues which might lead to some surprises. So if you want to find that out, check out my latest jailbreak tutorial and keep your eyes peeled. Until next time, Dr. Root 7 signing off. Peace.